Databases as a service are becoming more and more popular with things like Planetscale, we have Superbase, we have Nhost, we have all these platforms that offer databases. But what if you need a database that's both scalable and easy to use if you're not a programmer? Well, that's what we're going to be looking at today. We're going to be looking at Xata, which is a database platform that looks like Airtable, but runs kind of like Planetscale. So let me introduce you to Xata and how it works. So this is the Xata platform. As you can see, it's the serverless database of your dreams. It feels like a spreadsheet, similar to Airtable, but is completely scalable, has branches, zero downtime migration, ACID transactions, has a built-in search engine, analytics, and a bunch of other stuff. What's really, really cool about this platform is they're taking on just cloud functions in general. So if you have a platform on Vercel, Netlify, Cloudflare, AWS, Google Cloud, or Azure, all of those are supported by default. There's no special way to access the data. It's just API calls. So regardless of what programming language you pick, this will work for you. Importantly, it is type safe and very lightweight with a very small SDK, and we'll kind of get into how that all kind of works. But let's actually log into the platform and start looking at how it acts as a user. So I'm logged into the platform now, and you've probably seen a database similar before. Here you have configuration, which tells you what your workspace API is, what you give it as the name, and how many members you have right now. Obviously, the only person is me. Then you have your databases, and of course, you can add more workspaces as maybe you have different platforms or different databases, different workspaces that you need with separate members. So let's look at this basic example, which is filled full of data that they've provided. Now, as you can see, right out of the gate, it looks like a spreadsheet. Now, I'm zoomed in a bit, so it's probably not going to look quite like this because I have to zoom in at 125, but you get the idea. Here we have all sorts of things. We have labels, we have a slug, we have text, we have an author ID, we have the author's name, email, author, etc. And then we also have a users table here that holds all of those users. Now, what's really awesome about this is you can use it in many different ways. If we wanted to know how many of these articles were written by Millie, we could use this just as you would a spreadsheet. So you have options here. You can click filter, add a condition, say where, and then author ID is, and then the keyword would be M-I-L-L-I-E. And then we can click off this, and now we can see those results. So from a standpoint of a user that has no technical skills, if they understand how a basic spreadsheet application or Airtable, Google Sheets, Excel, whatever, they'll be able to use this. Then, of course, we can sort by columns. So maybe we don't care about the views and we don't care about the text. We just want to know this information. You can click that too. Then we can actually use this as developers and get the code snippet that we need. So if you click this button here, it will create the exact request that you need to use with the Xata client. So instead of having to be like, okay, this is what I want this, it will tell you how you can do the exact thing that you want. You can select JavaScript or TypeScript or Shell or whatever you might need to make this work. Click copy, drop it in your application, and then you'll have that reliable data every single time. On top of that, you can also use the search engine, which is really cool. So if we need to know Millie, for example, in here, it will show everywhere the word Millie shows up, gives you a relevant score. You can click this to expand it and say, this is the edit record of a user. I can make changes here. I can target stuff. So maybe I only want to target, let's say, the author. So I can press this and click just author here, and only records for that author will show up. We can get rid of users. Now we're getting the same results again. You can also add a booster. So this booster here allows you to select something in here, and it uses the algorithm with decay to sort of give you a relevant score based upon that. So for example, maybe you have an API reference, that's what you're using Xata for, you've got your API documentation, and maybe you have version 3 and version 4, and you want the relevance to be more on version 4 than 3, you can use a booster to kind of do this if they share data across the way. So let's say we say a date booster here, we select the column which would be post created, we set the scale, so let's say it's like 10 days, and then we set this to 69. You can see that these records are changing based upon that. So if I turn it down a little bit again, you can see that these are being ordered based upon this, and we could boost this all the way to 100, and you see this one is first, and then this comes out underneath. So you can also go in settings and set your fuzziness score. So if you know that people may be making typos or can be slightly different, you can set a fuzziness score. And then you can also set prefix type, which allows you to match basically on full words if it's disabled, otherwise it has to return the phrase. So that's the basic understanding of this. Then you can set of play around with your own code. So you can say, run code here, and it will get all of our posts here paginated. So as you can see, all of our posts have arrived, and you can make your queries here if you want to. Very similar to GraphQL, something like that. You can sort of check that out. Then of course, you can sort of play around with your history as you make these calls. And that is basically Xata in a nutshell. So what we can do now is actually go into some code, and I can kind of show you how you would set up a project and how you would query that data. Okay, so I've created a Next.js application here. It's just the create next app. And now we're going to init a database using Xata. And we can do that by doing Xata init. And it will ask you some questions based upon it. So we're going to create a new database here. Obviously, I could link it to one of these if I wanted to. So let's create a new database. We'll call it examples one. And then it's going to ask us how we want to generate our code. So if you're a TypeScript user or an ES modules or a CJS, or you just want the JavaScript SDK with no code generation, you can do that too. So we're going to generate with ES modules. It's going to ask you where you want to store it. So if you prefer utils over source, or you have a specific directory that you want this code gen to be in, you can do that right out of the box. And then it's going to ask if you want the TypeScript declaration. So we'll just hit yes. And now it's going to go ahead and ask us what branch we want this on. So we want it attached to main. And do you want to add the .env to gitignore? So we can say yes. And now we're ready to go. So what's really awesome about this for me is the random data. So when you're trying to try something out for the first time, maybe you want to insert some random data. Maybe you need to edit the schema. So let's look at the schema in our application first. So if we go to Arc here, and I go back to my databases here, and now there'll be examples one here. And if I select it, you'll see that there's no schema right now. So let's make a table. So let's start an empty table, call the table name to-dos. So let's add some columns here. So let's say we need a string, and we'll call this to do. We'll give it title, we'll create column. And then we'll add another one, and we'll give it a long text here. And we'll say to do. And then we'll add one more column, and we'll say Boolean, for example. And we'll call this completed. And we'll create that column. So now we've created that, we can flip back into our code here. And the first thing we need to do is run the code gen so that it redoes everything in there and grabs the new schema and does that. So we can just do Xata code gen, hit enter, and it will go ahead and generate based upon that new schema. So now it's been generated. Now I have the option. I can start using the code as is and start inserting things into the database, or we can use this random data, which I love. It allows me to essentially test without having to worry so much about, like, I've got to generate all this code myself. Let's just have them do it for me. So if I do Xata random data, it'll go ahead and randomly insert 25 records into our table. So if we flip back to Xata now, you can see that this has all been inserted. We have record IDs, we have titles, and then we have our to-do, and then this will always be false by default. So now we're ready to go. So if we open this in Visual Studio Code, put ourselves here. Now let's look at what we have. So first of all, we have all our types here. It gives you exactly what they are. It gives it all of the types based upon the schema that you have. Then we have this Xata.js, which tells you what tables that are contained in your current schema. So we have a to-do table with three columns, type boolean, type text, type string. Then down here, it has the database URL and this Xata client that we can actually use to create our connection and start using them in a serverless way. Also in this Xata.rc, it just tells you what the database URL is and where the code gen exported it out. In the .env, real quick, before we go any further, it'll have an API key and then the fallback branch. If there's not a branch available as your Git branch, it will use this as the fallback. So from here, we can just go to our index.js and let's use server-side props to grab some data. So we can do export const get server-side props. We'll parcel the context. And then inside of here, this is where we can start working on the code. Up here, we need to import that first. So we can do import Xata client. And that's going to come from that source directory. So it's going to be dot dot slash source slash Xata. And now we have access to this. We can create a new client as we need it. So we can go down here and say const Xata equals new, and then Xata client. And at this point, now we have access to whatever we need to make these requests. So to make requests is going to feel very similar to Prisma or anything else you may have used where you're using an SDK. It's going to be Xata.db. And then whatever ours is, which is to-dos. And then from there, you can then say what you want to do. So you can do all, get first or throw, get iterator, get many. Obviously, if you want to do reads, you can do read or throw. You can search, select, sort, summarize, update or throw. Plenty of different things we can do in here. So what we're going to do is we're going to get all. And we're not going to have any other piece to this. So we're going to call this const to-dos equal to this. And then all we need to do now is return that, right? So we can just do return props. And we'll just return the to-dos and hit save. At this point, this is ready to go. So what's going to happen is we're going to create this as a server-side props. Then we're going to make a request to our database in the to-do section. I'm going to get all of the records for that. And then we're going to return those records. Before we go any further, we should make this asynchronous. So we can just do async and we'll await this to return data. Then we'll go up here and we'll say to-dos, hit save, and we'll just console log out the to-dos for now. So let's go ahead and test this out now. Let's go ahead and run our application. We can just do yarn dev here and that'll run our application. And it's on 3001 because I have another application open apparently. So if we flip to Arc and then go to localhost 3000, so we can do localhost 3001. Open this up. You see nothing's changed here, but if we open up our console here and we go to console, you'll see there's an array of 25 pieces of data. And if we zoom in a bunch, you can see that we have the data ready to go. So inside of each one of them, completed false, here's the idea, here's the title, and here's the to-do. So at that point, we could do whatever we wanted with it. We could just loop through them and show them on screen, or we could handle the data however we needed to. So there we have it, a very basic introduction to Xata and their new serverless database with an Airtable-like feel. If you did enjoy this video, make sure you're subscribed as there's a lot of cool content coming up. I'm going to be vlogging both the next conference, the Jamstack conference, and I'll also be at Modern Frontends Live in London. So I'm going to do a vlog there as well. So if you want to know what conference look behind the scenes, make sure you subscribe because I'll be dropping those videos. Until the next one, see ya.